Hello, this is Angela, and today we're going to look at how to paint the nose. Before we start painting, let's have a look at some of the anatomy. Here we have a skull. You can see that the nose is right in the middle of the face, both vertically and horizontally. Notice where it is in relation to the eye sockets and the mouth. Here we can see the simple planes of the nose. You can see the main parts of the nose. Let's have a closer look. We have the bridge of the nose, what is often referred to as the keystone of the nose, the ball of the nose, and the wings of the nose. And below we have the nostrils. Here we can see a bit of what's going on underneath. We have the two main areas of cartilage on the nose, the upper and the lower cartilage, and the nostrils are made up of fibrous fatty tissue. Pay attention to the blue area of cartilage and the line that separates. This area of cartilage is sometimes visible, and particularly the line that separates the cartilage. Here we have a selection of noses. I've taken these screenshots from an app called Anatomy 360. I'll put a link to their website in the description of the video. Noses come in many shapes and sizes, which makes them particularly fun to paint. If we're looking at the keystone area, you can see how the angle can be very different. This one is even pointing upwards, and then this one is very down. Also, you can see how the bridge of the nose can vary in shape. Nostrils are not a particularly attractive part of the face, and so often it's better to play them down. But you can see here how different the shape can be, and how some people's nostrils are completely hidden. From the few quarters, the shape changes again. And then from the front, sometimes the nostrils are even triangular. You can also see here how the shape of the nose can change with expression. This gentleman has a very expressive face, and the expressions are perhaps a little exaggerated, but it's very interesting how the shape of the nose changes. Look how different the bridge of the nose is here. Now let's have a look at how Anders Zorn painted noses. Notice how he keeps the values very simple. We have this half tone here that goes up into the eye, and then there's shadow underneath, a bit of shadow here with that ridge, and then the light area of the nose with the highlight. Let's look at another one. Again, we have very simple values. That shadow here and on the edge of the wing of the nose. And then the highlight. And again, very simple values. That shadow area and on the top of the wing of the nose and under the nose. Very simple. A bit of half tone here. And again, very, very simple. Half tone here. Light on the front. Bit of light on the nostril. And then the shadow. The nostril and underneath. And when I say simple, I don't mean easy. It can be very difficult to control values. But luckily, Rebelle has some great tools that we can use to control our values. One of these tools is the colour wheel. I'll show you how I have mine set up. I have it as a circle. And then I have HSLUB selected. And hue ticked. For the grid settings, I have it on 9x9 and 36. So what does all that mean? It means that if I pick from the same row, although the saturation changes, the value stays the same or very similar. It also means that I can change the colour and again keep the same values. I'll show you another way to control values as I'm painting. The painting on the left is of Anders Zorn himself. I also found some photos of him to better understand the shape of his nose. First, I'll paint a general skin tone as a base to paint over. Now on a new layer, I'll sketch out the nose. I'm basically grouping together the shadows and the halftones into one value at this stage. I would usually sketch in just the shadows to find the placement of everything, but as this painting only has shadows in the eye area and under the nose, I'm including the halftones in the sketch. I'm thinking about how the nose slots into the keystone area. Instead of trying to judge the length of the nose from the top to the bottom, I find it easier to measure from the eye area to the top of the wing of the nose. Shorter distances are much easier to judge. Halftones are actually part of the light, areas that are lit but not as directly as other areas. Here I'm adjusting the size of the drawing to better compare it to Anders Zorn's painting. And now I'm adjusting the colour. Thank you. Now on a new layer, I'm painting in areas of colour variation. You will see the mouse move up to the colour swatches at the top sometimes. When I do this, I'm pressing X on my keyboard to pick up a small amount of colour from the swatches, which will mix with the colour already on the brush to slightly change the colour. I will also pick up a little white from the canvas at times to slightly lighten the colour on the brush. The nose can sometimes be slightly redder or even purple, particularly in the lower half. It's also common to see some coloration in the area near the eye. Here I'm building up the darks. When I'm painting the holes of the nostrils, I find it beneficial to soften the bottom area. The top of the nostril has a firmer edge. The bottom edge should be softened, even if you feel the edge looks sharp, to show the hole goes up into the nose. Also pay attention to how the ball of the nose transitions into the septum between nostrils. The skin is pulled quite tightly over the nose, which makes it a shinier area of the face. It's very common to see highlights on the bridge, ball and wings of the nose. Studying the way other artists have approached various subjects is a great way of learning. You can then go on and practice what you've learnt by painting from photos or from life, and then try it from imagination if that is your goal. I used the levels filter here to darken the middle value slightly, and I'll use the lighten layer to lighten those areas of shadow at the top. And that's all for today. If you have any nose tips, let me know in the comments.